Welcome to the Geography Department, the Sixth Form College Colchester. I'm here today to talk to you about why you might choose to study Geography and what you can expect during your two-year A level. So let's start by introducing you to the Geography team. My name is Chris and I'm the current Head of Geography, and we have five other Geography teachers: Lewis, Sue-Ann, Steve, Natalie and Anthony. We are all experienced Geography teachers and have taught all aspects of the course. When you start at the sixth form, you'll have two geography teachers. One will teach you the human topics and the other will teach you the physical topics. I'll talk a little bit more about the course later. Before we start looking at the geography course, I should also mention that within the geography department, we also offer environmental science and geology A levels, both of which can be studied alongside geography and are excellent courses in their own right. So let's start by thinking about what geography is. It's not an easy question to answer. Most people think about geography in terms of human and physical and how the two things come together. Now I'd like to give you an activity to think about what geography is. So for this, you'll need a pen and some paper. In the comments box below, you'll see there's a link to a music video. The video is full of ideas about what geography is. So if you follow that link, I'd like you to watch the video. It's about 3 or 4 minutes. And note down as many ideas as you can. There should be about 15 to 20. Okay, hopefully you've written down lots of ideas. I've listed just a few of the key ones on the screen. As you can see, geography is very much about how people interact with the world. So you can see many of these images are the impact that man has had on things like oil spills, links to climate change with the polar bears, conflict, inequality and poverty. You may have also seen images about food insecurity, obesity, any issues relating to animal conservation, poaching and the ivory trade. Many of these issues link to overpopulation and urbanisation, which is where we have too many people living in confined spaces. So when we start to think about what an A level in geography might be, these are many of the issues and topics which you'll be studying in your two-year A level. Now, if we look at the A-level geography course, as you'll see, there are four topics that you'll be studying in your first year. Two of them are human topics, two of them are physical topics. If you've already studied geography at GCSE, you'll probably be familiar with some of these, particularly coasts and migration. These are the first two topics that will be starting in September, so many of you, you'll be aware of the issues, for instance, relating to coastal processes, like things such as erosion, weathering, and the formation of beaches, sandbars, spits, and tombolos. In fact, if we have a look at these eight photographs, some of you might be able to recognize the famous coastal features. To help you out, I've listed some of the options below the photographs. The answers will be on the last page of this presentation. Now, the other topic you'll be starting in September is global migration. This course looks at why people have been moving around the world at a faster pace than ever before and what the impacts of that are on society and the environment. We look at lots of examples, from the famous Mexico to US migration corridors to the Eastern European movement to the UK. Now I'd like you to have a quick look at the image on the right and think about what that image shows. A key skill required by A-level geography students is to be able to analyse graphs, maps and photographs. I should also mention that you'll be required to complete a piece of coursework in geography, which is worth 20% of your final mark. The coursework will start at the end of your first year, and as you can see, the topic or question is chosen by you. We'll give you a few options of areas you could investigate, so coastal salt marshes or beaches, or even town centre studies. You'll continue to work on this over the summer, and we'll then review your progress in September, and you'll hand in the completed version in November. Moving on to look at the assessment. Now, whilst this table might seem a bit confusing, the main message is that there are three exams and one piece of coursework. The exams are essentially a physical paper called Physical Systems, a human paper called Human Interactions, and then a third paper called Geographical Debates, which is worth the most amount of marks. and that's a mixture of human and physical issues. As you can see, the coursework is listed at the bottom there, and that's worth 20% of your final mark. Now I'd like to finish by just mentioning some of the field trips which we run in geography and which we hope to continue running in the years ahead. As you can see, we've taken trips to Italy and Sicily as a tour of the volcanoes. The trip's usually about a week long, and you'll get a chance to see Mount Etna, Vulcano and Stromboli, which are three of Europe's most active volcanoes. And we also run a weekend trip to Bournemouth every year to explore some of those coastal features which we mentioned earlier. So as you can see, there's Old Harry, Durdledore, Lulworth Cove and Chesil Beach. So I'd like to finish by saying thank you for listening, and the Geography Department hopes to see you all in September.